was History and Introduction. That chapter also included the history of early man, Stone Age, the three Stone Age, New Stone Age, Middle Stone Age and the Old Stone Age. After completion of that chapter, chapter 1, I have skipped chapter 2, 3. Chapter 2 and 3 I have skipped, I have straight away come to chapter 4. This chapter is connected to Indian history, therefore I have come to chapter 4, mind it. After chapter 1, you come to chapter 4. The chapter 4 is the River Valley Civilization, Indus Valley Civilization. See the map here. Can you see the map? Can see India, Pakistan, and the yellow region is the region where Harappan civilization developed. It would be good if you can draw this map in your classwork copy. After this, you have to, after studying this chapter, you have to do an assignment. The assignment you will find at the back, and I will give you, this assignment must be there in your copy. Here is the assignment. This is your homework. Can you read the questions? Assignment 1, given in page 122. And then you have to come to assignment 4. Assignment 1 and assignment 4. Practice assignment, page 122. And assignment 4, you will find in 126. I will be correcting your answers when school reopens. Please do it in your classwork copy. This is given page 126. So assignment 1, assignment 4, and you have to do another assignment, that is the third assignment. Rural self-government, this assignment, page 134. This is your holiday homework, assignment 1, assignment 4, and practice assignment 11. And I will be also showing you the first page of the third chapter which you have to study. That is Rural Self-Government Panchayati Raj. This is the third chapter you have to study. Civics, rural, self-government. This diagram is very important. I will modify this diagram and give you. Functions of panchayat are very important. This is a small chapter, but from this chapter I will be asking you 30 marks worth questions. So chapter is small, but 30 marks questions are going to come from this paper. 30% of the marks will go to this small chapter. So it is worth studying. 40 marks, history, 3 or 4 chapters will come. But in civics, there is a single chapter and it carries 30 marks. So the first, you give priority to the study of civics. Panchayati Raj is our concept, the entire Panchayati Raj, rural self-government. Panchayati Raj system is the oldest system of local government in South Asia. In India, it was first inaugurated at Nagpur in Rajasthan in October 1959. Andhra Pradesh was the second state to establish it by Constitutional Amendment, 73rd Amendment Act 1992. It was extended to other states also. You may be living in an urban area, you may be living in a rural area. Panchayati Raj exists in rural area. In urban area, we have the municipality. The ward councillors. Okay, that is from the book I have shown you. I have cleared your all doubts regarding the textbook. The earlier version and this version, both the books are equally fine, equally good. Only the matter may be rearranged, sequence may be rearranged, but the contents is same. The questions are same. So any book you have, both are fine. Do not phone the school, call the school and ask which book to follow. Both books are okay. And most probably the bookseller will give you the latest version. That is fine. There is no change in content. The publisher and the book is same. Only that was 2019 edition. This is 2020. So I have cleared your doubt. Please do not call school office for clarification regarding the textbook. This textbook is also okay. And the previous version is also okay. Some students have got the old stock from the bookseller. Some students have got the latest stock. This is the latest stock. Now today's main concept I am coming into, today's main concept is Indus Valley Civilization. We have earlier studied that after Neolithic age, agriculture developed, and when agriculture developed, there was a need for people to live in one place. Living in one place provided protection to the people. Now, when we live in one place, then there need to be discipline and social rules and administration. Without administration, people in a large group cannot stay. And that's why a language is also required. But those days, language wasn't developed. So they wrote in pictographs. And this, all this civilizations, they developed beside rivers. Why beside rivers? Because they need water. Even today, every Indian city is beside a river. Be it Bokaro, Garga River, be it Ranchi, Subarnarekha, be it any river, be it any city, it is even today located beside river. What are the advantages of being located beside a river? River provide abundant supply of water for agriculture. Population could be supported by it. Without water, no population can be supported. The land near the rivers were extremely fertile for agriculture. Rivers provided means of transport and communication. The river valleys did not suffer extremes of climate and were warm and pleasant. The four first civilizations grew on the river banks for this reason, because there was abundance of water, and without water, man cannot exist, a large population cannot exist. So, what were the four civilizations? The first one was Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamian civilization grew in between two rivers, Tigris and Euphrates. Second one is Egyptian civilization. The Egyptian civilization grew beside River Nile. River Nile is called the life of Egypt. And Egyptian civilization grew beside River Nile. The Chinese civilization grew beside River Huanghu. And Indus Valley civilization grew on the banks of River Indus 4,500 years ago. So the four civilizations are Mesopotamian, Egyptian, Chinese and Indus Valley civilization. Now what is a civilization? When we start producing enough food and begin thinking of new things, man thought about a settled society, better food, better clothes. He also learned how to read and write. He began to use knowledge to improve his life. He started taking part in leisure activities. Thus, we can say man looks for more time, more than just fulfillment of his basic needs. The stage is known as stage of civilization. During Stone Age, man was only concerned about his basic needs. He was a food gatherer, nomad, then had a settled life. Still, he was after only his basic need, that was food and some clothes and some shelter. Now, after agriculture being developed, man had more leisure time. So he wanted to satisfy, man is a social animal, he wanted to satisfy himself. There were other needs also. And those needs were fulfilled. That is civilization, our culture, our food habits, our way of living, our thinking, all this constitute civilization. Our literature, for example, the unique drainage system of Indus Valley civilization reveals the town planning skills of the people. In Stone Age, there was no need for drainage system, but in towns and cities, we have drainage system. Now, what is the characteristics, features of this civilization? There are four civilizations, but we will be now studying only the one civilization, that is Indus Valley civilization. The Indus Valley civilization, how do we know about this civilization? Especially in this northern, the Pakistan and India border area, people started digging. While digging, they found out some articles, some buildings, some towns, some cities, some bricks. They reconstructed it, the entire period from this. Imagine if a storm comes or a pandemic comes, and if we perish, and after thousands of years ago, somebody comes to this city, he will get our remains. And from there he can construct the history of Prachi. In 1921, this was discovered by Ram Dayaram Sayani. Dayaram Savani discovered Harappa in 1921. In 1922, Rakhal Das Banerjee discovered Mohenjo-daro. This nullified the theory that the first people who came to India from Southeast Asia were Aryans. The people who lived in area before Aryans came were Dravidians. Probably these people were Dravidians. Still we find Dravidians in southern part of India. Brought to light the fact that a very advanced civilization existed in India 4,500 years ago. And this area covered Pakistan too. That means we have a civilization which is more than 4,500 years ago. Mohenjo-daro is located on the bank of river Indus. Indus Valley civilization appears to have developed from diverse agriculture communities. All those who came were agriculture communities. The site was discovered in 1974. Like America today is made from people coming from different areas, different countries. More than 256 sites were discovered in large parts of North and Central Asia. Lothal, Kalibagan, Banavali, Alamgiripur, Dholviria. This table is very important, given in page 27. Now, the sources of history are from various sources, Gate Bar, Citadel and other places, what we have discovered from there. Now, I am giving you a diagram. Old cities were discovered in, the oldest city discovered in India is Harappa. Oldest city discovered in India is Harappa. Now, how did the people live? The very important aspect of this civilization is the town planning. So, I am coming to town planning. The town was divided into two, upper part and lower part. We see upper Chutia and lower Chutia. But the entire city was divided into upper part and lower part. The upper part means the region was not at the same sea level as the lower part. This is a higher region. And this higher region and lower region, the difference is, if there is a flood, this upper part won't be affected, only the lower part will be affected. And what did they have? They have the granaries here. They had the great bath. And in lower part they have, what they had? They had the workplace. And entire town was here. Upper part had the granaries, the temples, and the great baths.